Don't we have the answer? If Congress had wanted to strike the whole law down, they would have. They chose not to. They chose just to invalidate the individual mandate and leave the rest of the law in place. So how can a judge in Texas, even if I agree with him ideologically, how can a judge in Texas say, well, what Congress intended to do, or this law can't survive without the individual mandate, Congress must not have known what they were doing, but Congress did it. Congress just did it this year.
But I think that there's an argument to say that the GOP-led majority, House and Senate, because they attacked only and repealed only the portion that made the law constitutional according to the 2012 decision, there is an argument to be made that Congress intended to strike at the heart of the law, repeal only the portion and basically the linchpin to the entire law, and therefore make the rest of it unconstitutional just as that particular. I think that's an argument to be made. I don't know whether or not the Supreme Court will by that, I will tell you, Liz, it will be very difficult for Chief Justice Roberts in particular to have any other rationale that the rest of the law survives the constitutional framework and a threat and a challenge to its constitutionality on any other basis, because he already has said that the individual mandate is the only reason that he found it constitutional in 2012.
Right. He did say that. We'll see if he's consistent. Here's the other problem that I have with this severability, and I want your analysis on this, too. When you're talking about this concept of severability, meaning if one part of a law is struck down, it would invalidate the rest of the law. Courts, this is a judicial philosophy. It's you know, existed. It's not really partisan. It's a Supreme Court tradition. But how does it play into this when the part of the law that was struck down, the individual mandate, wasn't struck down by a court? That was actually found by the Supreme Court to be constitutional. It was Congress that repealed it. How can Judge O'Connor in Texas justify what he did when it was Congress that made that choice, not a court?
Well, I think that goes back to what I just said in the earlier portion of this, which is because Congress chose to repeal only the individual mandate, which was the reason that the Supreme Court held the law overall to be constitutional, there's an argument to be made that Congress intended to invalidate the whole law because it essentially took the enforcement mechanism out of it. They took out the very reason that the Supreme Court found the entire law to be constitutional to begin with. And so if you take out that linchpin, then the rest of it unravels. I think there is an argument to be made on the severability issue, but I think that this presents an even better opportunity for the Supreme Court now with Justice Kavanaugh, and again with all of the analysis and all of the constitutional conservatives really disappointed in Chief Justice Roberts for his analysis in 2012. This gives him and the rest of the court an opportunity to revisit the scope of the law as a whole and say, you know what, healthcare is not an issue that's given by the Constitution in Article 1, Section 8 to the federal government to begin with. And because they're trending more federalist properly, they have an opportunity to invalidate it as a whole and say, states, you need to determine what your position is on healthcare. That's an individual question. It's not a federal question. So I think that that's also a possibility of an outcome here.